All right, I'm going to show you how to find the mean, the median, and the standard deviation using an online graphing calculator if you don't have an actual calculator to type in the information. So what you're going to do is you're going to go to the website called Desmos.com, D-E-S-M-O-S.com, so Desmos.com, and that should take you to this website here. We're going to click right in the middle where it says graphing calculator. You don't need to log in or create an account or anything. Just click on graphing calculator and you'll be brought to an online graphing calculator where you can graph lines and do a bunch of other things that we can look at later on. So for right now, all you're going to do is go down to the bottom and click on show keypad, where everything will pop up, where you can type in numbers if you want, or you could just use your regular keypad, but all of your extra options are underneath this menu. You're going to click over on the right hand side where it says functions. And we're going to first start seeing a bunch of trig functions here. So a bunch of trigonometry functions pop up. We are going to click on the menu across the top that says stats. So when there are statistics menu, you're going to have a bunch of statistics functions that we can use. We're going to look at mean, median, and standard deviation. So now that we know how to do mean by hand, you would take your list of numbers, add them all up. Once we find that number, divide by the number of values that we have. You can check that answer really easily using this function online. So it says mean, it has parentheses. Just make sure you are typing inside the parentheses, and you're just going to go ahead and you're going to add in your points. So I'm going to use the points for number one in our notes, which is 100, 58, 77, 52, 87, 99, 105, and 78. So I'm just typing them in. I'm not using the buttons at the bottom, but you can if you want to. So I just typed them in using my keyboard. My parentheses are there. You hit enter, and it tells me my mean is 82. So it's a quick way for you to check your work and make sure you did everything right if you did it by hand. The only thing is, if you type in one of these numbers wrong, then obviously you're guaranteed to get your mean incorrect. So you do the exact same thing if you want to find the median. Median, we put all your numbers in order and then find the middle number. And if you have two, take the average of the middle two. So I'm just going to copy this list of numbers, as long as I know I typed them in correctly, and hit enter. So my median of that list of data is 82.5. So just keep in mind, if you type something in wrong, now I have two incorrect answers. And then the last one is standard deviation. So standard deviation, we have not learned how to do by hand because it is extremely complicated and time consuming. So we're just going to come to your menu here. We're going to use standard deviation. So notice there's two of them, if I didn't mention that already. Standard deviation, STDEV, click on that for standard deviation. I'm going to paste my list one more time and hit enter. Your standard deviation is 19.58.